Assalamualaikum. How are you, students? I hope you are doing good and completing your work and learning your lessons regularly. So in the previous clip, we did the first part of exercise 9, and in that part, we made a map about different aspects of personality of Qaid Azam. And today we are going to make a map on different aspects of personality of Allama Iqbal. So today we are going to do exercise 9, its second part. And we have been asked in the book to discuss academic achievements of Allama Iqbal, his dream about Pakistan, and his advice to Muslims. So, but we are going to discuss Allama Iqbal as a great visionary, and we will discuss this in a broad spectrum. We will cover all the points which have been given in the book, and including to this, adding to this, we will discuss some more points so you could write a good composition. So let's start. Allama Muhammad Iqbal is also known as, is very famous as the poet of the East. And he is known as the poet of the East because he composed poetry on Eastern ideologies and principles. And he also did poetry on Islamic philosophy. And when we talk about his academic career, so we come to know that he got his early education in his hometown Sialkot, and then he went to Government College Lahore, and he did his masters in Arabic from the University of Punjab. And after that, he went to London and got a degree of law and became a barrister. After that, he went to Germany to achieve the highest university degree, PhD, and the University of Munich awarded him the degree of PhD on his work on Persian philosophy. And when we talk about his professional achievements, we come to know that first of all, he became the professor of Arabic at the Oriental College Lahore, and after that he got a law degree and became a lawyer, became a barrister. And we all know that he was an excellent, intelligent and wise politician who did a lot for the betterment of Muslims of South Asia. So now we have a lot to discuss about his political services. And in his political services, we will also discuss his dream for Pakistan. So, first of all, he was elected as a member of Punjab Legislative Council in 1926 and remained on this post till 1929. Meanwhile, he was involved a lot in the activities of All India Muslim League. So, he became the president of Punjab branch of All India Muslim League because of his political acumen and because of his commitment and devotion for the cause of Muslims. So this was he who dreamed for the separate Muslim state of South Asia. So we can say that he had a dream for Pakistan. So after that, we will talk about Allahabad address. His Allahabad address is one of the greatest achievements of Allama Iqbal. And he delivered this address in 1930 in the meeting of All India Muslim League in Allahabad. And this was that historic occasion that then first time he demanded for a separate Muslim state publicly. He demanded a Muslim India within India. And this demand shocked everyone. This demand shocked British rulers as well as Hindu majority. But this demand, this word did not stop there, and this became a seed which he planted, and it expanded, it stretched, and it flourished a lot. And at last, there was a separate state for Muslims on the map of the world. And this was also Allama Iqbal who motivated Qaide Azam to work for the independence of Muslim, to work for the freedom of Muslims of South Asia. And after that, there was Pakistan Resolution. Pakistan Resolution was passed on 23rd March 1940 in Lahore, and this was the fruit of Iqbal's effort and struggle, because Iqbal was not alive in 1940, but this was because of his struggle, this was because of his work. And at last, we got independence of Pakistan, we got independent state for Muslims. So this is all about the political services of Allama Iqbal. Now come to his aspirations for Muslim. So he had great desires, he had great ambitions for Muslims, because he loved Islam very much and he had a strong faith in Islam. And when we read about Allama Iqbal, we come to know that he advised Muslims on different occasions. And once in Allahabad address, he said that this is Islam which saved Muslims, but not Muslims who saved Islam at the difficult moments in their history. And he also advised Muslims that if today you put your faith in Islam, you will become strong and united once again and can save yourself from complete destruction. So now this is our duty, this is duty of Muslims to work hard, to be united once again and to have a strong faith in Islam, so we could be stronger again, so we could get our lost glory and standard in the world. Then this very great leader, this intelligent and wise leader, died in 1938. And on his death, Qaide Azam appreciated him. Qaide Azam sent a message to tribute him, and Qaide said that, "To me, he was a friend, guide, and philosopher. And during the darkest moments through which the Muslim League had to go, he stood like a rock." So girls, all our great leaders had done many greatest things, many great things. And now this is our duty. This is the duty of Pakistanis to work very hard and to struggle for a great Pakistan, to struggle for a peaceful, prosperous and progressing Pakistan. So we should do our task, as Pakistan has been gifted to us by these leaders. And we should remain this gift, we should flourish and develop this gift in the form of progressive and prosperous state. So this is all about today's topic. And now what you have to do, you have to make this map in your grammar registers in the portion of composition. And after that, you will write a composition on Allama Iqbal as a great visionary, according to all these aspects, according to all these points. Alright girls, so this lecture ends here. Inshallah, in the next class, we will meet again with a new topic. Till then, take very good care of yourself.